and we're here today to do a focaccia, a traditional flat Italian bread that is basically cooked with rosemary, parsley, salt. It's a very simple batter, but we're not gonna use rosemary because we don't have, and probably you wouldn't like it, so it's just sea salt. So now we're gonna say the ingredients. Let's go.
Agora vamos colocar 5 gramas de fermento.
140 ml.
We already put here a half tablespoon of yeast and 140 ml of water. You're gonna need
1.5 colher de colher de sopa de açúcar.
1.5 tablespoon of sugar.
Aí agora é só misturar.
Now we're gonna just mix. We're gonna need this. And 2 tablespoons of flour. So you mix and then let it rest for about 10 minutes.
Esse aqui foi o resultado final.
You see, it has popped up some bubbles, but not a lot. That is it.
Agora vamos colocar o azeite e o sal e misturando farinha de pouco em pouco.
Now we're gonna add salt and olive oil. Now that it's all clean, we're gonna mix with salt too. So it's olive oil, salt, and that's it. Now we're gonna mix. And we're gonna add the flour, step by step. So our batter has to be very thicker. It has to be thicker than this.
Vou colocar a cuchara.
So now we're gonna mix until it becomes a very thick dough.
Tá bom, vou começar a mexer com a mão.
Alright, so we're gonna put our hands on the batter.
A massa, ela tem que ficar assim mesmo, mais meio pegajosa.
The batter has to be a little bit stick, you know? When you put your finger, it cannot back to you.
E a gente vai deixar ela descansando coberta, assim, totalmente, sem deixar espaço. Por mais ou menos em torno de meia hora para a massa poder dobrar de tamanho.
Now we're gonna rest the batter for around 30 minutes until it doubles. With a tower one, you know? Oh, it's actually a plastic paper. In hot days, it could be in summer days, could be around 20 minutes to 30 minutes. But in the winter, it could be 40 minutes by an hour. So it has to be aware of the weather. Even to it doubles. That is very covered. We're gonna let it rest.
Agora, assim que tiramos, né, que deixamos descansando para a massa crescer, untamos a forma com azeite inteira e vamos deixar aqui para descansar mais uns 15 minutinhos.
After the batter grows, we're gonna put oil in the pan and throw our batter in here. You're gonna distribute right here, and yeah, you're gonna rest again for 15 minutes, and then we come back.
Agora que a gente deixou descansar uns 15 minutos, eu vou furar. Bom, para quem tem o dedo pequeno, é bom furar com o polegar. Para quem tem o dedo maior, pode furar com qualquer um, até com o dedinho se precisar.
Okay, after 20 minutes, we're gonna pop our thumbs in the batter and make some holes. Look how pretty.
Agora vamos colocar o sal grosso em cada buraquinho.
Now we're gonna put some coarse salt in here, just a little bit. If you wanna put into the holes, it will be better.
Agora vamos colocar o azeite.
And for finish, we're gonna put a drizzle of oil here.
Agora é só colocar para assar no forno de 200 graus Celsius.
Now we're gonna bake the stove in for about how many? How much time?
Quanto tempo? Em torno de uns 35 minutos.
For 35 minutes. By 200 degrees. Over 35 minutes, 40 minutes. That's it. I'll come back later.
Uou! Tá pronto aqui. Esse é o resultado final. Pode ter vários acompanhamentos, salame, cream cheese, tomate com cebola, não, é com alho, e muito azeite.
So now that's ready, you can eat a focaccia by herself, on itself. You can eat with cream cheese, or with tomatoes, with garlic, whatever you want. Bye!
Nossa, que delícia! Nossa, tá muito bom!